Hi there, Eric Bakker. Got lots of questions. Always got questions from subscribers and different people, preferably subscribers. Is zinc carnosine good for stomach issues? Zinc's a very important mineral for people to have in their diet all the time, especially for males, but for anyone who's alive. If you've got a pulse or a heartbeat, then you'd probably need zinc in high amounts. It's incredible how many people I've seen over the years in my clinic with zinc deficiency. You can do a zinc taste test if you go to your whole food store and ask for a small bottle of zinc tally or zinc taste test. And just read the instructions on the bottle to test yourself for zinc. Zinc's very important. You can't make stomach acid without zinc. So you need zinc, B1 and B6, I believe. Those are the three core elements you need to make stomach acid. So the stomach can't produce proper acid with zinc, and zinc can't be absorbed without good stomach acid. So it's quite a vicious cycle. So with the good acidification of that stomach, again, remember I've mentioned this in other videos, you can't convert enzymes from the pancreas to the active form. So when zinc is in good amount and the pH of the stomach is nice and low, it will stimulate also the pancreas to create this stuff called picolinic acid. And picolinic acid is very important because it's one of the main binding mechanisms for trace elements to get into the body. So we're talking like chromium, molybdenum, vanadium, selenium. Many of these trace elements will not sufficiently be bound, they can't be bound. If they're not bound to picolinic acid, you can't really get them in. So, but zinc, what I'm saying is zinc's one of the main mechanisms to allow this to occur. So zinc really overrides, in terms of its deficiency capacity, most other micronutrients or trace elements. So it's one of the key ones you've got to get right. But the question is zinc carnosine. Well, zinc carnosine is basically zinc bound to carnitine, and again, which is a composite of a few different elements. But studies have definitely shown that zinc carnosine is particularly good for stomach acid. I've just read an interesting study from not that many years ago where they gave people a drink, something to stop the mucosa from getting irritated from hyperacidity. And they also gave people zinc carnosine around 100 milligrams per day to see which one had the better effect. After several weeks, there was no doubt that zinc carnosine had a significantly more protective effect on the gut and improved the person's well-being over taking this, this mucus sort of layer drink that the person was having. Most people who take PPI drugs, proton pump inhibitor drugs, will really benefit from zinc carnosine. Zinc carnosine has even been used in high dose short term for Helicobacter pylori patients. So, but in my opinion, zinc picolinate is also just as good. So, one of my favorite companies, Thorne Research, I started to use their zinc picolinate many, many, many years ago, like 20 something years ago, and I found it to be fantastic in clinic. So males lose more zinc with one, emission or ejaculation than a woman will lose in literally 30 days. So men, and the reason being is the seminal fluid contains reasonably high amounts of zinc to buffer that solution, which would aid in infertility. So men definitely have lower levels of zinc than women. And zinc, if you look at oysters, were always considered to be the main aphrodisiac for guys. And oysters are also nature's highest zinc-containing food. So males really could do with zinc. I've personally found that zinc, I started to take a lot of zinc years ago, not that I was deficient in it, but to experiment what would happen. And I found my sense of smell really increased and my taste increased. So what I urge everyone who's watching this video is to do a zinc taste test to make sure that you've got good zinc levels, because zinc's critical also for RNA and DNA transcription. So if you want to prevent a lot of nasty diseases, you need to have good cellular reproduction. And zinc will prohibit, a wonky or dodgy kind of a transcription there when it comes to creating new life. So zinc's critical for that. Also for women who are going to conceive, they need good zinc levels. Zinc's imperative for white blood cells. Leukocyte activity doesn't really happen properly without good zinc levels. It's also very antiviral. And more recently, I've discovered the power of zinc when it comes to neurotransmitters. So zinc really aids people also with anxiety to a huge degree and also depression. Zinc, B6, and magnesium is the classic triad, which we call the glucose tolerance factors. So having enough zinc in your body also stops you from snacking on crappy food. because it helps to regulate your blood sugar to a higher degree. So now you can start to see how excited I am about zinc. I think it's a real good thing to have in your diet. So there you have it. Is zinc carnosine good? It's real good. But get your zinc tested, all right? Have a great day.